beans, creams, potatoes, tomatoes, lamb,
where's the rabbit?
Beans, creams, potatoes, tomatoes, chicken, turkeys, rabbit.
You name it!
Beans, creams, potatoes, tomatoes, lamb, ram, hog, dog. Beans, creams, potatoes, tomatoes, chicken, turkeys, chicken, turkeys. Beans, creams, potatoes, tomatoes, lamb, ram, hog, dog. Beans, creams, potatoes, tomatoes, chicken, turkeys, rabbit.
You name it!
Beans, creams, potatoes, tomatoes, beans, creams, potatoes, tomatoes, beans, creams, potatoes, creams, potatoes, beans, 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 creams, potatoes, tomatoes, chicken, turkeys, chicken, turkeys, beans, beans, creams, potatoes, tomatoes, chicken, turkeys.
You name it! You name it! You name it! You name it!
Time. I shouldn't have left you. Without that gangster music, you get ripped to
real. It's bad. I'm back.
It's been a long time. I shouldn't have left you. Without that gangster music, you get ripped to
Mic check, mic check, mic check. What a time, my dames. It's your boy Montoyis and the Reese, and this is the Shoot from the Hip Show. Pre-Thanksgiving Day. Yep. Up in here.
You know.
There it is, man. Yeah, you can find us at 559-825-SHOT. That's the voicemail line. Call it in and get it off your chest. Shootfromthehip.xyz is the main website. That's where you find everything we got and make that donation that we cherish so well around this camp. Instagram, Shoot From The Hip Show. Twitter, From_The_Hip. And that's where you find your boys kicking it on the internet, man.
Right, player.
What it do, man? D. Reese.
What's up?
What you sipping on, dog?
I'm sipping on some 12 years.
See, there
old.
You go.
Gotcha.
You ain't in the mic.
I'm in the mic.
Yeah, all right, brother.
I'm in there. Mic swung well.
Without the chin here. Gotcha. Gotcha. All right, man. So I got a joke for you, man.
Let's go.
Well, hey, did you, I didn't tell you about the time I dated the girl from Al-Qaeda, did I?
Mm-mm.
She was a bomb.
Badoo-ching.
Badoo-ching. Took that me a minute to get there, but I got there.
You got there. There it is, my toys with the jokey joke.
Knee slapper.
Extraordinaire. There you go. Man, you need to try for the Apollo or BET Comic View next time it come around. Because comes back
you know,
once in a while.
Nah, we didn't walk past the Apollo. We walked past the Radio City Music Hall or something.
Mm, same thing, man. You get your own special.
Yeah, I get in there.
Mm-hmm.
Make it happen.
Yeah.
Jail, man. We getting around here getting ready for Turkey Day, dog.
Getting ready for Turkey Day, Turkey Day Eve or whatever.
Yeah.
The day before Thanksgiving is usually a hot night in the club, man.
Yeah, that's correct.
Usually.
And we in here.
We in my club.
Yeah, Club Day Reese.
There you go.
Yeah.
Just as fun, you know. You just ain't going to be looking at no stunners around here.
Drinks is cheaper.
Yeah, that is true.
And that's better to me than the stunners.
Yeah, hey, I hear you on that.
You understand me?
But we back.
Yeah.
That's right. D. Reese, D. Montoyis, we back. Back on. Look like we getting back on schedule, getting this thing back right.
Yeah, man.
Shout out to the sheriff. Yeah, man. I don't have no breath this time, I hear.
No, we don't.
No breath. So it's just going
to
be us.
It ain't had nothing to disagree with, man. 85% of the time, I'm right, dog. I told you that.
Yeah.
Now, you on the other hand, maybe you've been more right than wrong lately.
Because
you know you talk out your ass and have people calling in on you.
What? Yeah. No, I speak facts, B.
Well, you speak flats, nigga. Like flatulence.
Nah, I speak facts. And sometimes people can't handle the truth.
You be farting out your mouth, nigga.
Take that too. Anyway, we back. Looks like he said he gave you all the information. Y'all need to get in contact with us.
Mm-hmm.
I guess it would be time for me to do a gunshot, but I'm not ready because we listen to City Girls.
Yeah, man. Hey, y'all. I don't get it, man.
What you don't get about it?
I don't. You didn't plug the thing in, did you? For the gunshot.
I do have it in, but
all right.
It's not reading my iPad right now.
Oh, damn it. Apple products, y'all. Yeah, Reese had me listen to some music from the City Girls.
Yeah. put that on me.
I know. And I can't believe, I don't know how this man come across the ratchetness that he speaks out against so much.
What you mean?
And then he turns around and puts me on it. Now I'm not going to be able to unhear that shit.
Well, first of all, that's hotness.
It ain't. Why is it's not? Refreshing that it don't sound like the Migos.
They are down with the Migos. They down with QC.
Yeah. I'm down with Black Tone and I'm down with the Fuck.
Oh, yeah?
Oh, dang. Oh, fuck.
They down with QC.
Yeah.
We got Yachty. Migos,
yeah,
Lil Baby,
yeah,
Cardi B,
okay.
Well, that's a lot of ignorance, boy.
Yeah, it is, man. So why do you keep coming across that?
That when I don't support it, I sound like an old hating ass.
No,
nigga.
That don't mean go find the trashiest rap you can find.
That
act
City
like
Girls, oh, they got a song with Drizzy, Drake.
Yeah, that don't justify it though.
It don't.
No.
I don't know what the
fuck. It's, like I said, it's refreshing that they don't sound like the Migos and all that other old funny ass flow they've been doing.
They down with Migos, though.
That's cool, but they ain't trying to sound like them. I'm pro anybody sounding like themselves, dog.
Well, not too many people can do that.
They can, they don't.
Well, I mean,
the industry don't want to do it.
No, I think so much shit has been said and the same shit has, you know, kind of been regurgitated over and over.
I've been watching a lot of Unsung here lately.
Yeah.
And it reminds me of the time music flipped.
Yeah.
Yeah, I was watching The Kid and Play One.
Yeah.
Yeah. Damn, you gonna yawn in the mic too? What, you tired?
Yeah.
Should have brought you a little, like a 5-hour energy or something.
Nah.
And then you gonna put that Mac Allen on that?
Yeah, I know, right?
Nigga, you gonna be snoring halfway through the show.
Nah, I ain't fuck that, nigga.
Bang!
Shit, everybody snoring ass motherfucker. This is Shoot From The Hip Show. So the other day.
There it is.
I was hanging out with the Montoyis. Came over there, kicked it like Claire. You know what I'm saying? That boy's getting busy.
Yeah.
You know, moving around. We was in his cold ass garage, smoking on stogie, talking shit. Old lady made some gumbo.
Oh, yeah, that's right.
That shit happened.
That shit happened.
Yeah, till he went around the back and fell.
Yeah, well, I was so lit, dog.
Nope. So he fell. So me and
Ashley. I was expounding on it, dog. I wouldn't disagree.
Well, okay, because there's two. This happened twice. So you got to explain both of them.
Well, I remember knocking shit over the second time. I don't remember falling so much.
Okay.
But I did stumble backwards on that first one. Yes. I stepped on something, knocked my balance off. Once I started on that Makers, I stayed on that Makers.
Yeah.
And it showed.
What you drinking today?
I had a little shot of your Mac Allen and a Modelo.
Okay.
That's it.
Classic man.
But yeah, Lee Reese them came over, man, and I was having a one man party, then they showed up and it was a two man party, then a three man party. And
So the first one, let me tell you, he's in the back, he went in the back and he just kinda you know how you finna fall back when you roll your arms back.
Oh, you know come on, dog. That didn't happen.
Oh,
like
it
that.
Happened. And then you just went, poop. So me and Ashley looked at each other like, did this dude just did this? I thought it was a fluke, but I knew he was getting
that was definitely not a fluke.
Okay.
I was there. And
so we went inside for a good minute. We came back out.
Yeah.
Ashley was trying some of the old lady gumbo.
Yep.
And then we got to jam.
Yeah.
Ree was quoting lyrics and shit, jamming that hotness.
Yeah.
And I had my cigar going. Next time I know, knocked my beer bottle down, broke the glass, knocked my lit cigar. I knocked his shit ashes all over the place.
Yeah, that happened.
And then I was like, it's time to go.
Time to go, dog. I'm tearing shit up. Time for me to put the bottle down, man.
Hey, man. Hey, come here. I always get a drunk ass do that goddamn shit.
I was having a ball, y'all.
He drank too goddamn much.
Ain't nothing but a motherfucker drunk. But yeah, man, old lady, she cleaned up after me.
She did?
Yeah, nigga.
Shout out to the old lady.
Nigga,
she knows she got it.
I went climbing to bed, and she said she closed the garage door and picked up the shit.
Oh, shit, son.
But then I woke up like, wait, nothing wrong. Jump straight to it, dog.
And got right back on it.
Hey, well, no, I eased into it.
You sure about that?
Yeah, because you said you showed up the next day.
Did
it? Yeah, you like, nigga, you sober.
Oh, and you was real sober. No, nigga, I'm good today.
Yeah, I'm chilling today, man. You know, hey, any of y'all out there that got right was in the safety of your own home. You tell me what's wrong with that.
I ain't said nothing wrong with it. I just said I enjoyed it.
Oh, yeah. Well,
as long as it wasn't me.
That's all right, man. You know, I get there sometimes. Mm-hmm. I don't whine, dog. Nothing wrong with that.
All right. So,
see.
The Rams and the Chiefs played the other day. They scored 100 plus points between the two of them. One of the highest scoring Monday Night Football games
ever. That was outstanding, dog.
So me, my boy Archie, my boy Sam, and two of my other partners that I care not to mention their name, we went and chilled at the sports bar and watched the game. We had a good ass time. Had a grand old time.
Man, you were hitting that sports bar.
You got to do that,
look
dog.
At you, dog. You look like you hooked.
Well, I know a few people stood me up. You, the BYT, Fliggity.
Whatever, I ain't stand you.
Ashton played hooky, talking about him tummy hurt.
Well, nigga, at the night I had, it's probably best that I just carried my ass home to the house, man.
Okay.
Come on now.
All
right. I know how to rock the boat when I fall off that motherfucker. I just fall down in the garage.
So I'm out of my glasses now.
Yeah.
And
you gave up your distinguished look.
Yeah.
Should have kept it, dog.
So I could look like a motherfucking savage, nigga.
Well, there's that.
Yeah, gutter nigga. Trap shit. Slap a nigga trap.
You looking like a suspect with that goatee.
Hey, man, that's cool. I'll take that. My rap sheet clean.
So you got to watch that nigga. Look at him. Look like a movie villain.
I'll take that, too.
Look like a second-tier henchman in a Batman flick.
I take that too.
All right, man. That's no cloudy, dog.
It's all good.
Oh, man.
It'll come back around.
Oh, well, you shit, man.
The next time you fall.
I was just going to say, you just clown me for busting my ass. Oh, let me give me some get back up in here, man.
So,
you got plans for Turkey Day?
You know, I do. Oh, but I want to talk about my glasses.
Okay.
So I had to wear my glasses, doctor's orders, for a week.
Oh, yeah. Nigga, this energy is terrible right now.
We good. Hold on.
Man, what you doing, man?
Son.
All right.
So anyway, I went in there, and he was like, well, you're back to normal. The eye infection is gone. You can put your contacts back in. All
right.
But he said, you're getting close to putting bifocals on.
Ooh. What hell, what were they?
Reading glasses.
Okay. Some readers. Everybody wear readers.
Nigga, no. Nigga, that's a sign of old age.
Nigga, guess what?
Yeah.
Hey, you are there, homeboy.
I'm like, oh, man. I don't want to be putting that glasses on, hanging off my nose.
Yeah, hang off your nose and then cock your head back, look through them when you read something.
Yeah, like scoot back and look at
looking
it,
like a shade tree mechanic. All you need is a cigarette dangling out your mouth.
Nah, nigga, that's like a whiner right there.
Man, now see what you got here. Something wrong with your carburetor. Your Cadillac converter.
Yeah. Well, I also want to see if you were going to order that turkey I told you about. For those of you who have not had a great smoked turkey, you need to try Greenberg turkey.
Hey, man, cha-ching up in there. We need some
Hey, man.
We need Cash App. They need Cash App us or something.
Man. Hey, man. It's going to happen, dog.
All right, now. That's all this free promotion.
Hey, man. That's going to happen. So, shit.
So, you ordered one, apparently.
I have. Oh, I have mine coming to me.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. You ordered.
Well, I did order, but somebody bringing it.
Oh.
Yeah.
Oh, so somebody coming from up there.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, so they bringing it for me. So.
All right, dude. Yeah, right on.
Mm-hmm.
So it's y'all having it here?
No. It's going to be at mother-in-law house in the Mo. In the Mo, nigga. Or that Missouri City.
You know the answer to that. Around here, disrespecting,
so,
man.
It's safe over there?
Yeah, most definitely.
Okay, I'm just saying. Well, yeah. I'd rather be safe.
I got a story.
Go ahead. Quick.
My old man was on one yesterday.
Okay.
You know, so when
drink your choice?
Bailey's.
Okay.
And so he gets to getting on that Bailey's, and reality bends a little different for him.
Mm-hmm.
Then when, you know, other folks drink and they drink.
Yeah.
He's sitting in the garage and he usually just mind his business.
Yeah.
Jam a little bit and wave his hand. Well, he was out there on the Bailey's in his garage yesterday.
Yeah.
In the Mo. That's why I brought it up, because that's the
minding mode. His own business.
And he sees his neighbor about to set up the turkey fryer.
Okay.
Inside the garage.
Ooh.
Inside the garage. And my old man got this thing about fire. He had a dramatic experience at work with it.
Yeah.
And so anytime there's a fire incident that looked like it's about to happen. He gets a little sensitive about it.
Yeah.
So he watched it until he couldn't watch it no more. And he went over there to tell that brother that's not a good idea to do this.
Yeah.
Dude tells my old man, I've been doing this for 10 years. Ain't no problem here.
Okay.
So they had a back and forth. My old man said, all right, you got a fire extinguisher? And before old buddy could finish, homebody said, no. My old man got on going down the road.
Yeah.
Said, fuck this, I'm done.
Yeah.
But then, so the old buddy took heed to him, pulled his shit out the garage, then put it right in front of the front door.
What?
Like he didn't get the message at all.
Yeah.
So I went over there today, man, and he pointed out, see, you thought I was just drunk, talking crazy. He pointed across the street, and I be down. It's the stand, the pot, and the propane tank all sitting right upside the front door, dog.
Really?
Just waiting to blow the front door off that bit. I so hope it don't happen that way.
Well, now I'm going to ask you something about this. Does this happen only in the Mo?
I don't think so.
Okay, because Mo City got some shit now.
I don't know, but I know that there's going on. Mo, man,
he probably frying a turkey right now.
He might be.
How long it take to fry a turkey?
I depend on how many pounds it is. Yeah, okay. I think it's like 10 minutes per pound or something like that.
Okay.
Some shit like that. Or, I mean, it averaged about 40 minutes
now,
or so.
Now, BYTY didn't want him to fry no turkeys. He thought he going to blow the house up.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Well, I don't know.
Hey, BYTY, he fucked some shit up too now.
Even back time, they might know how to do that.
Well, yeah, you know you might be right.
You know, he probably been doing that for years. However
he probably hunt his own shit.
He probably dropped that shit in with his finger.
He probably kill that bitch barehanded. Snap the neck off that motherfucker.
Anyway, man.
Meet BYTY.
Oh, shit, there it is. So he gonna call in now.
No, yeah, he don't listen to the show.
Yeah, so that's what the Mo do now. Where your mother-in-law stay? They not doing that.
They not doing that.
They having theirs purchased. Hey. And they shipping them in, dog.
Work smarter, not harder. Hey. So the Yahoo Fantasy Football app was down the other day.
Yeah.
So I was winning when I was at the sports bar.
Okay.
Some kind of way it showed me losing, then it showed me winning the match, but I got hit with a loss. So I went from first to third. I'm like, what the so fuck? How the fuck do I fix this shit?
Okay.
So, yeah, Twitter acted an ass, and they fixed
it. Oh, so it's a lot of people.
Yeah, but they fixed it.
See, that's one thing Twitter's still good for, man. Yeah. Letting people know when they done did something wrong.
Mm-hmm.
You know? They won't hit you when you're doing right, though.
Mm-mm.
Won't get a whole lot of that, but boy, when you screw up,
oh, yeah.
Yeah, the Twitterverse gonna get you.
They coming.
The Twitter hive.
And they's came. And they fixed that shit. So your boy's back on top. What? It's the Shoot From the Hip Show. 559-825. 7468. 559-825. Shot. Let's get the girl shot. Bang! All right. Let's talk some news. So, you know, driverless cars are coming soon.
Soon?
Well.
They are not here already?
More prevalent in society.
Yeah, more ubiquitous.
Yeah. So
you're getting infrastructure in the cities now.
So it's going to change the way people work and live. Apparently, it's also going to change where people have sex at.
I heard about that.
Yeah.
I heard that the prostitution is going to take advantage of this.
Yeah, big time.
Yeah.
Yeah. And
they be ordering Uber.
Yeah.
It's going to be spinning the gooch in the Uber.
Well, going to be some messy ass cars, bro.
Ooh, man.
Cum stains all over the goddamn car. Man. Spitting shit from the girls getting in the goddamn
screw
gooch
the pay by
shit.
The hour tweeties and all that. Ain't no more of that.
Yes, the statistics say 60% of Americans have had sex in a car.
Hey, you
have
getting,
you?
Huh?
Have you ever had sex in a car?
Oh, yeah. Well, I just
that's
a
not
lot of
comfortable,
that.
Man. Like, it's hard to breathe in that motherfucker.
Well, I mean, you know.
You gotten hot and heavy and steamy and shit.
Yeah, but when you in there, it really don't matter.
I've seen, like, on Twitter, like, some pretty cool, like, why didn't I think of that?
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Like, it's...
Yeah, well, I can say it did.
Oh, they got
yeah.
the Bang Bus from the Bang, bro. They ride around Florida some shit.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Well, I bet Toyota going to make them Priuses. They going to make them compatible, dog.
Yeah, I know, right?
Ooh-wee, what about them Teslas, nigga? They on the cutting edge.
They are.
I can see them seats laying all the way back down for them.
Well, I'm sure Elon Musk is all over this shit.
Yeah, man. It got to be.
We got problems anyway with stockholders and shit like that.
But, the SEC was after his ass.
Okay. Yeah, I know. He outsmarted him. The smart guys always win.
Mm-hmm.
An Albuquerque woman is suing Samsung for $1.8 million.
What for?
Her name is Selma Bryant, and she put a Samsung phone in her vagina as a dare. Soon after, she realized she couldn't get it out.
Oh, shit.
Yeah, so she went through a lot of psychological issues.
Hit that Kegel on it, huh?
Yeah, she said she wanted to feel the vibration. She Kegeled too much, and the bitch got stuck.
She hit the volume rocker. Yeah. Got so it stuck in there.
When it was unable.
She should have said, okay, Google.
I know, right? Then that bitch would have vibrated a little bit.
Hey, okay, Google, get out of there.
They got vibrators with remotes.
Yeah, I know.
So you with your old lady, you could walk around and just, you have a remote. Yeah.
Wear out.
Getting back on topic. So the thing was stuck in her twat for 96 hours.
And she's suing Samsung for that.
Yeah, she said there was no warning on the dangers of the potential risk of inserting it into your vagina.
Wow. They need that? Yeah. I bet you this.
Some people do.
They're going to put that in their warnings now. They're going to win that. Samsung's going to win that. But they are going to have to put that as a warning in the packaging now.
They should find a way to sue her stupid ass.
She ought to catch something for that.
She on that crying and shit. I'm like, you a fucking idiot. Motherfucking bitch.
That's crazy, man. But see, she's probably in Albuquerque, New Mexico. That's a meth place.
Yeah.
She probably strung out on that meth, dog.
I can see that.
You're right. That's a good meth place.
Appreciate you for yawning in the phone. Hey, man. In the microphone.
Did you have to be burp?
Yeah, actually. Yeah. Yeah, that'll work. Hey, man, it ain't that late around this bitch, bro. Them kids wearing these Reese out.
My kids are bad as hell.
They kicking your ass, man.
I'll send them with you. You can have some of that action, boy.
Hey, man, look here. You know I run a tight ship.
Yeah, I don't know.
Well, see, the thing is, it ain't just me.
Yeah.
See, Marshall wear the old lady out. Yeah. He don't wear me out.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay.
So she'd be over there hovering. And I'd be in the garage with the monitor on. Like, they all right.
Yeah.
Poke my head in there. Hey!
You know what?
Close the door.
I got some articles I forgot to get more information on. We're going to move on to this. $1.5 billion Mega Million lottery winner has yet to claim
his prize. In South Carolina, right?
Yeah. April 21st.
Probably Geechee in them lowlands over there.
Now, he got a ton of money. They say he's giving him $65,000 a day in interest.
Man. Geechee Gula, man. You better go get your money. And quit playing around.
They said that could be some anxiety from
having the ticket and not wanting to cash it.
And anxiety, yeah, to being rich. And also, there's also anxiety rich about anxiety. Your life being ruined. Because so many people's lives have been ruined by winning the lottery.
I don't think that's the case, dog.
And they also might be setting up their estate as well.
How about that? That'd be smart.
Yeah. So
look, I just won, so I'm going to need you to get this shit straight before I cash this check.
Yeah.
I'm with that.
I
don't believe in no anxiety, man. Come on, man. Who made that study?
I mean,
same ones say don't whoop your kids?
Possibly.
Yeah.
A group of doctors probably got together.
Pussified doctors. He's just nervous from being rich. Who ever heard of a nervous millionaire?
I don't know, man. I sure would like
unless
to try
they didn't fuck somebody over and got a reason to be nervous.
Man, I just want to try it.
Hell yeah, I tried. I doubt I'd be nervous.
I'd be nervous.
I would not be nervous.
I would. Will Screw we still that. Make some shoot from the hip show?
Yeah. Are you serious? Well, I'd be advertising this bitch like a motherfucker. Know, man, they wouldn't miss us.
Yeah.
Shit.
Yeah. Well, I tell you what. I'm going to give it a shot. I'm going to keep playing, and I'm going to pray I keep winning.
Yeah, well, you can't win it unless you
come on, Pastor.
Yeah.
Woo!
Somebody turn to your neighbor.
Neighbor?
Shit. Hey, I posted something on Instagram where Pastor got mauled by a lion.
I seen that.
Yeah.
God was going
to
work that out.
He's trying to prove that he can stand in front of the lion, and the Lord was going to intervene and not let that lion maul his ass.
Yeah.
A little too late. Didn't have him for him.
Like he did black people?
Yeah.
Hey.
Hot take by the Reese.
Hot take.
Cotton candy.
All right, moving on. The fourth largest building or tallest building in Chicago had an elevator malfunction.
Man.
Did you hear about this?
No.
They dropped 84 floors.
Dropped 84. Yeah. Man, oh. I would stay out of a building after that, dog. For real. I'll take the stab, dog. I might not get but to the 20th floor. But screw that.
Yeah.
I've had elevators make a little funny move. dog. I'm more scared of an elevator falling than a plane having turbulence and shit.
You know, the percentage is very low.
Yeah, I know.
But whew,
dog,
that'll fuck
that man.
But like I did the you dragon can't
control
drop.
That. That's you did what?
The dragon drop. They had this. Okay, so Astroworld back in the day, the thing that Travis Scott know nothing about.
Yeah, that's a good, nice shot.
They
man.
Had the was it Star Scream?
Sky Scream.
Sky Scream.
I that's what I was finna bring up.
Okay. So then they came, they like, oh, that wasn't high enough. They came up with the dungeon drop.
Oh, I remember that.
So I did the dungeon drop, did it several times. So I
you was cool with that.
I did it.
Fuck that. When I worked there, that was they said, okay, your first day on, enjoy the park. Yeah. Ride everything, do all you want.
Yeah,
I ain't get on shit but the sky screen. I said, if I can handle that motherfucker, I can handle the rest of. I got on there and they trick you at first because before it drops,
you're supposed to hear that noise. You can hear it when you're down here. When you're up there, you don't hear it though.
It's a horn. It's like three beeps. Mm-hmm. And so you know you're in line waiting on it, and you're anticipating that beep to get ready for it.
You don't hear it.
What they do is. They drop you in the middle of the second beat.
Oh, really?
Oh, nigga. Because I'm on the ground, and maybe I'm not registering that they're dropping them before the third one. But in my mind, it was getting beep, beep, and beep, drop. Well, when I was up there, it was beep, beep, drop.
Yeah.
And I lost it, dog. I got up off, and it wasn't but like a half a second, 2 second drop, something crazy like that. Didn't take long, but it was long enough for me to know that I am not fucking with no more rides.
Well, I tell you.
Fuck that.
The scariest thing. Well, I'll tell you two things. We can go to a break here. So the Texas Cyclone, that was like the big.
That was that the was, one.
That was the
when
one.
When it dropped. That I was the one.
And what made it so good, it was raggedy.
So yeah, it made that noise.
Motherfucker be shaking and shit,
man.
It was white. It was you seen it from a mile
I
away.
Felt like when I worked there, they should have condemned
when
that.
When you drove by, you could see the motherfuckers on that bitch dropping, woo, and dropping. When you
and
drove
you could
by.
Hear it when you're in the park.
Yeah, and
like,
so
no, they need that. That's not good.
So I used to like this chick. She a dope thing now, but I used to like this girl, and we got on there together. And I always liked because I used to really, really be into dark skinned girls at one point. I was like, oh, I just couldn't get enough of that.
Yeah, get you some of that dark of the berry.
Oh man. Oh, so we get on there, man, and we kind of bracing ourselves, man. That motherfucker going up that click, 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 click.
Yeah.
And that bitch dropped. She said, "Oh shit!" And her titty popped up out of her shirt.
Oh,
and I'm like, "Oh!" And I'm like, dog, "I'm forgetting
you still,
about
you." Still cognizant and aware of everything.
I'm like, "Fuck
the
this ride!"
The ride didn't have nothing to do with it.
I ain't worried about none of this roller coaster.
You saw some areola.
I saw that titty. She grabbed that motherfucker and just said, "Whoop!" I'm like, "Oh fuck!" I'm like,
so she was still with it enough to put that thing back in there
because I was gonna help her.
Oh, yeah, I bet. Cause you're such a helpful guy.
Yeah.
Such a gentleman.
And so,
yeah, baby, let me help you with that.
We got out of that mud. She's running there. I'm like, you going to act like this titty didn't bust out?
Yeah, you're going to act like we. I just didn't see that.
Yeah. So, anyway.
Man, it was life or death situation right there.
Hey, man. I still remember that
you
to this day.
Better man than me, dog. I could not do it.
Hey.
I was Mr. Hold Your Stuff while y'all got on the ride. I did not do it, man.
And screw then, that. Another one was the Ultra Twister.
Yeah.
Okay,
that.
So the Ultra Twister to me was the scariest ride sitting in the front.
Yeah.
When you sat in the front, you was the first motherfucker to, and you couldn't, it wasn't like, you know, I've did the front and I did the back of all the roller coaster.
So it's always worse at the front.
Yeah, so okay. I got to the front of the Ultra Twister and that was pretty fucked up.
Yeah.
That pretty was. And then they had the looping starship.
Okay.
And the looping starship would swing. And
yeah,
swing,
that
one.
Yeah.
That
I remember
motherfucker
that.
Would go up there
and hang for a
and
minute.
Hang for a minute and change be dropping galore.
Ooh.
But nope, you never better get that chain because nobody will be able to go there when that big ass motherfucker is
yeah,
up there.
Yeah, you can't get it.
And I remember some of the advertisement. Every year they run an advertisement. I remember the advertisement used to come on when they brought that new ride to Astroworld. Anyway. We just going back through some old shit.
Yeah,
it's
we
shoot
are.
From the hip show with Montoyis and Reese 559-825-7468-559-825 shot. We're gonna take a break. We're gonna come back with the fucker. We always got put in that cause you know there's always niggas out there doing some dumb shit.
You know you gonna find it.
That's right. Hit us up on Twitter, hit us up on the voicemail if y'all feel to do that. Or you can email us. Since y'all not calling, go ahead and give us an email. LaShira, email me so you can email the hate toward me when I burp. How about that? This the shoot from his show. We'll be right back.
Potato salad. Now that's my favorite right here. Who made a potato salad? This motherfucker.
Oh, shit. Why? Huh? Why, nigga? Huh? You don't walk into a fast food restaurant and ask who's on fries, do you? Huh? No, do you roll up in the Roscoe's and ask who's grilling the motherfucking waffles? Huh? No, you don't. So why does it matter who made the damn potato salad?
It don't really matter.
Exactly my point. Now scoop some up on your punk ass plate and shut the fuck up. Now!
Scooping, nigga.
Eating all of it.
Scoop right here.
He didn't mean it, Mookie.
That's another scoop.
There's two scoops. No, he didn't mean it. There's nothing wrong with your potato salad.
Yeah.
Your
potato salad is dry.
Like the desert.
Dry. It is not dry. I just didn't have enough mayonnaise last year. That's right.
What about the year before last?
All right, dude. I mean, what about that nasty ham that grandma makes?
What?
Well, I thought it was good.
Shut up.
You about to get your ass whipped, boy.
Since we're speaking of nasty, what about this nasty ass raw turkey we be eating every year?
You better watch that turkey mouth. You know what, some bitch? I'm gonna tell you one goddamn thing. I didn't want you at this goddamn Thanksgiving dinner. Now, this turkey is good. This is a good goddamn turkey. It ain't nothing wrong with this turkey. The turkey is just rare.
Grab my ass. The turkey is raw. It's raw every goddamn year.
Fuck you.
Last year, you cooked up the damn plastic bag with the giblets still inside the goddamn turkey. And the plastic bag was raw.
You say another fucking word, I'll carve that ass right off your goddamn head.
Shit is raw and bad.
You raw, motherfucker. Your ass is raw.
That's why I have to drink this messed up punch to wash the shit down.
You say you let my punch pop it.
Hey, we back, y'all.
Oh.
Hey. Hey, dog. That skit, I feel like it's going to touch home so serious.
Hey, okay. So, hold on. So, you play this, and as I'm listening to it, it brought back memories, some shit I seen at your crib. I remember my wife
was
exactly
like, "That's exactly what I'm talking about."
My wife was like, "What the fuck is going on?" I said, "Well, shit.
Oh,
home
man.
Teen ain't tripping. Shit, I ain't either.
Oh,
fuck
I'm
it.
Not gonna be tripping, man.
Let him go.
Shit. I'll be honest with you, dog. I fully expect some shit like this to go down.
Oh, that's gonna be pretty good.
It's wrong." Shut your ass up, boy.
Hey, this happened at D. Montoyis' crib not too long ago, man.
I'm telling you, dog, this hit home. And I'm waiting on this incident, man. I'm waiting on it.
It was pretty good. I semi-enjoyed it.
Oh, man.
I semi-enjoyed it.
Man, we had business outside and inside at
that
day.
Yeah.
Oh, man, it's going to go.
Anyway. Wherever you are, I hope you enjoy your Thanksgiving, your turkey day. Hope you have something to be thankful for. It's the Shoot From The Hip show. Shootfromthehip.xyz, 559-825-7468, 559-825-SHOT.
Hey, this is what I want, man. I want all the listeners out there, if you ever had an incident similar to that in your family, call our line and tell us about it. Please, dog. I know I ain't the only one that go through some of this here, man. I know y'all out there dealing with some of that same shit.
That was pretty good.
Oh, man. I'm waiting on it, dog.
Yeah.
And who made the turkey?
Hey, man, that was pretty good.
Why? Now put some of it on your punk ass plate.
That is the clip that was played on the Instagram and the Facebook page. It's an excerpt from the
Who Made the Potato Salad movie. I just want some mac and
cheese.
That's
probably the last acting job that Jaleel White had.
Yeah, I think it was.
AKA Steve Urkel. AKA Stefan Urkel. So make sure y'all check it out. I see on YouTube they had a reunion.
Oh, Family Matters?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, yeah? Did Stefan show up or Urkel?
I don't know.
It's like, did Shock G show up or did Hump?
Yeah.
Yeah. Hey, man, I saw Shock G on some. I might have been on Unsung. That dude is weird as some bitch.
I bet.
He looked like.
Didn't nigga that came. I mean, it was kind of funny, but, you know, he still was a goofball.
Yeah.
For doing it.
Well, it worked for a minute there.
Yeah.
Because people thought they were two different people.
Yeah, they did.
But he's weird. He got like some old Frankenstein-ass hairdo.
Right now?
Yeah. Like he got like a gray streak.
Oh, like Kwame, but it's gray?
Yeah. I seen something ain't right with this. Hey, you still yawning, dog. I thought you was coming with the energy, man.
Hey, man, I'm drinking wine, beer, and liquor.
Yeah, dead wrong. It's a trifecta.
Trifecta.
Had your ass snowing on the microphone. Yeah. Yeah, like I was saying.
Wake your ass up. God, I remember I was fucking this bitch. Nah, let me stop.
No, say that.
No,
I know where you're going.
I used to message this chick. But I used to work at night.
Yeah.
And I would go over there and fall asleep on time. Well, after I got my work done. You know what I'm saying?
No, I didn't feel asleep in the middle of the work, man.
So I heard her say one time, she said, wake your ass up. Louisiana zone. Candace, y'all.
Oh, see, that name drop.
Shit, damn. You know,
man, I don't think there's any dude alive that's
hey, man, I've been hitting the front and the back and praying I don't throw up. That wasn't me.
As the Rockets won. Yeah, man, but yeah, nigga, I've fallen asleep on it. Not even a handful of times. More than a handful of times.
I can see that.
Oh, nigga, wake up, see y'all across the bed. You don't want to deal with me.
All right, man, we fucking off like a motherfucker. This is the second half of the show, and like we always do about this time.
Yeah.
Bam. All right. It's time for the fuckery. Idris Elba was named People Magazine Sexiest Man Alive.
Man, that's kind of old news, man.
Nigga, we don't record. Hey.
Okay, my bad. I ain't mean to shoot at. I felt like that was a shot at you that I shouldn't have took.
No, but the point is that it was between two people.
And who's the other guy?
Me.
Oh.
Nah, fuck around. Anyway.
Sorry, I missed the news, though.
The reason I'm bringing this up that I think is pretty cool that the black man. What?
Is he the first?
I don't know.
I thought somebody else had gotten that before.
Not a black man.
No.
Maybe.
Damn, boy. This nigga, man, y'all see this, man. This is something to behold right now.
Say, man, listen.
What? I mean, he's fighting it, though.
Hey, I'm in here.
This is
like
a slugfest.
Hey. I don't know, but I will. I'm not finna go along the list of who I think are sexier men that could have won this award. But
and what magazine is it?
People Magazine.
Okay, hold on one second.
Oh shit, here we go.
Hey Google, who's the first black man on People Magazine's Sexiest Man Alive?
I can search the web for that.
Boy, that means there wasn't one. As far as I'm concerned.
All right, Scotch gone.
Yeah, well. You got some more
of that. I do. I'm going to get to it. So anyway, but I think it's a great thing that a black man was acknowledged to be the sexiest man alive. I believe.
You think that was a good moment for the country?
I believe so.
In this world of Trump, you don't think Trump had something to do with that?
He had nothing to do with him being nominated, but I will say.
You don't think there was a counterculture thing?
No, I think it's a great acknowledgement that we that niggas out here slinging this goddamn donkey dick.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay.
And I believe that every woman
after we just talk about falling asleep on it.
Every woman that's not black. You know, again, I'm telling you,
oh, here you go.
Listen.
You about to say something.
When you go into porn,
here you go.
Ollie's porn searching.
Way to bring it there.
Yeah, what I'm saying is, matter of fact, you see what Cisco said?
Man,
Did you see it?
I haven't seen it. Maybe it's the last one. I haven't seen it.
You need to watch it. I would like to hear your reaction on the show. For real. Right. Yeah. I'll talk until you see the video. All
right, man.
But anyway, I think it's cool to see, but I'm telling you, a lot of women that are not black, whether you want to call yourself Asian, Hispanic, white, whatever, they all had dreams of fucking a nigga, a black dude that's gonna give them that straight wood. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Like, we're the most athletic, you know, fucking in sports and shit.
You know what that is.
You know that carry over into the bedroom. Niggas
quick,
around this
quick
bitch.
Twitch, dog.
Quick twitch muscle. See if you can turn it down. You don't need the sound. You don't need the sound.
All right.
You don't need to send. Just watch it.
Yeah, it didn't come through on the radio. I mean,
watch it on your phone.
I'm watching it now.
You are watching it.
Yeah.
Okay. Cool. 559-825-7468-559-825 shot. We got a friend of ours named Cisco Grizzly. His name in the pot.
Y'all know that man.
Yeah. His unprotected sex on in the fantasy football league, and he loves sex a lot.
Hey man, this dude has one subject matter.
Are you watching it?
I'm watching.
Okay. So while the Montoyis are watching this video, because he sent us a lot of videos with a lot of sexual innuendos. And
no, it's not even innuendo.
Well, yeah.
It's straight up buddy boot. booty butt ass. Naked ass.
Did he watch it? What are you looking at right now?
That's some dude hugging his granddaddy.
Watch what he give him for Christmas.
Oh, look at that. Look at Pops. Got him a card to Pornhub.
There you go, man. Come on, man. He out here winning, dog.
Wow. He said, I love you, grandson.
Get some bonus coverage. Oh, again, like we said, man, this is the second half of the show.
You know the way to a young man's heart.
Make sure y'all use the voicemail next time around. Now, like I said, we took a break, but we back, and we getting this shit going. And I also need to work on the fantasy football trophy while we're talking about that. And Cisco Grizzlies made a move in his fantasy football league.
Did he?
Nigga, he's in the playoffs, nigga.
Okay.
He's in there.
Hey, man. There it is. Hey, man, so who's making a potato salad at your gathering?
My wife and my mother-in-law.
Oh, so they tag teaming it?
Probably my wife, but.
Hey, man, it's important, man. I hate to bring it back there before you moved on to the best.
The best.
We just glossed over the sexiest man in the
Anyway, what I'm just saying, though. Anyway, shout out to Idris Elba for that. I think. You know, for us to get awards like that.
You doing that us yet?
As I'm just saying, for niggas.
We doing that?
Hell yeah, nigga. Okay. Shit, I'm a nigga.
All righty, sir.
That's what I'm recognizing.
I'm not taking credit for that.
I'm not taking credit for what I'm saying.
But it sounds like you did.
It's a great acknowledgement that these women out here want to get donkey dick by a nigga.
Whatever.
All right, nigga.
Don't make me no different. I know I'm good wherever I go.
Oh, bitch, I'm good.
Exactly. Shit.
Oh, shit, my dick game strong, nigga. Hey, shit. And, Kim Porter, the mother of three of Puff Daddy kids, passed away.
How about that?
At 47 years old. Said she had pneumonia.
You
think it's pneumonia? Did she snort coke?
I don't know. She was in that world.
Yeah.
So, you know, it's a good possibility. Definitely. I had Kim folk pass from pneumonia.
Did he snort coke?
No.
He had pneumonia.
Yeah, that's what they said.
One of my principals, he one who cast me to play Malcolm X in the play in middle school. He died of pneumonia.
Yeah,
yeah.
Oh, he was snorting coke.
I don't know.
Hey, you know what? Once again, I was going through a string of unsungs that I was watching while I was in the garage on the stogie.
Yeah,
Kim Porter showed up on one. I was watching Al B. Shores.
Real quick, if my wife is sleep. When you get done, I'm coming to smoke a stuff.
Okay. You know
that shit. Hold on. How you gonna do this?
What?
Well, once you leave here, your wife gonna expect you to come home and come inside.
I'm supposed to be picking up some Similac.
That's what the boy's drinking?
Yeah.
He ain't on whole milk yet.
Well, I mean,
Similac is disgusting.
We're making a tangent here. Yeah, I'm supposed to be picking up some Similac on the way home.
Okay, go ahead.
But now he eating solid food and all that now. Well, not solid, but spoon fed shit. But
the boy.
I was watching Al B. Shore's Unsung.
Mm-hmm.
If not last night, the night before.
Okay.
Kim Porter showed up on there. And I forgot that Puffy was parading around with Al B. Shore's son. Well, like that.
Because he got more money than Al B. Shore.
Well, whatever it was, all of that came up.
He's in that movie, Dope, or Fresh, or whatever that shit.
Yeah. But yeah, dog, I saw Kim Porter. I didn't know her and Al B. I didn't know that was her. I knew that there was some kind of connection with him and Puff.
Yeah.
But I didn't know Kim Porter was the connection.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah. And I like all this reverence she was getting all of a sudden.
I know, right?
The fuck was that?
Sweet soul and just
I've never heard nobody say nothing really good about her.
Really?
Yeah, no.
I heard she was nice.
Well, I guess. I never heard it.
Yeah?
Can't say I heard a whole lot either way. But whatever I heard, it wasn't good.
Like Kim Porter?
Yeah.
It was bad.
I don't remember. I just remember it was kind of like the Al B. Shore Puffy thing. And the sun and all that.
Well, she got some good pussy.
Well, whatever. I didn't hear that either. But I just like, man, when people die,
I mean, come on. What do you want to say bad stuff? You want to tell the truth?
Nothing. Yeah, please.
No, nigga.
Tell them, I didn't know that chick.
No.
That's Puffy baby mama. Shout out to her. I guess that's what they be doing.
No. The Montoyis is around here being a dickhead again.
I'm not.
559-825-7468. You want to call it, cuss his ass out.
Man.
M-O-N-T-O-O.
Hey, any one of y'all call me and tell me y'all really knew her before you gave it R.I.P. Y'all do that.
Yeah.
Yeah.
They wanted to rest in peace, dog.
Why? For what?
Why?
How you know she's even resting? What if that's just it?
Well,
it ain't no more. Huh? How about that?
There's that.
All right, then.
Nigga, Treyway, nigga. Speaking of Treyway, Tekashi 6ix9ine.
Yeah, that was, nigga, that was good, nigga, almost.
So he's on the Breakfast Club the other day. He goes on there and say, fight his whole crew. He started bringing up some shit about MTA booking and all that shit.
Because he moves so militant.
Yeah. So
that can't nobody touch him.
His former manager, Treyway Shoddy, was arrested for racketeering. So he does the Breakfast Club interview, which made a lot of waves. He talked a lot of shit on there because that's what he does.
That's what he does.
And that next day,
his ass was popped.
Yeah, he got arrested.
You can't help but laugh at it and be like, aha. Even if you don't want to sound like you're hating Doug, I watched Ebro last night.
Oh, I did. Did you?
I watched that last night for sure.
I heard a video from you played yourself.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And it's like, man, even though they didn't sound like they were taking glee in it, Ebro was definitely taking some glee.
I like Ebro.
And talking bad about this man.
Yeah.
And not to say that it wasn't deserved.
Yeah.
They spent a lot of time on it, though.
Mm.
They drug it out for a minute. It's like, hey, man, you could have said it in like 5 sentences, maybe.
Yeah.
But they drug that shit out. Yeah, they got a good 15 minutes out of that.
Yeah.
It's like,
so apparently they tapped the phones of some of his associates, and they found out that they wanted to dead him. They said he was in grave danger. Aside from him getting ready to get killed, apparently, according to the Fed, he gonna be hit with some RICO charges.
RICO?
Yeah, so the RICO, I guess the way the RICO charge works is guilty by affiliation.
I guess so, man. That's supposed to be for like
mobsters.
Mobsters.
Well, apparently these guys have gang ties.
Out of town ties. Out of country ties and shit.
Well,
like
that, but they got gang ties too. So are they going to apply it to these guys?
Fat Tekashi, Joe tried to tell that, man. Did you see that?
I seen that too.
Hey, try to tell that, man. They gunning for you.
Yeah. Well, it's over.
There it is. I don't know. I'm not going to say it's over.
His lawyer
said
these charges will be dry, but I don't think so.
It's just like Trump.
Just like Bobby Shmurda.
It's just like Trump being elected.
Done.
I don't want to see that it's not going to happen until it don't happen.
Done.
You sound like Ebro. Like, y'all are happy about this.
It's over.
All right, man.
The party's over.
I'm holding out my judgment.
The fat lady has some.
Nah.
What?
She might be humming. She ain't singing
shit,
yet.
The fat lady has sang. Let that bitch keep singing. Jill Scott is singing and sucking.
I saw a post, dog, that said, y'all out here talking about Jill Scott. Well, some of y'all ain't Jill Scott. He said, some of you BBWs ain't Jill Scott.
Like, I know,
y'all
right?
Are precious.
Oh, shit.
That's pretty good.
Man, look here. I think Cisco sent me something on that, too. He God sent me a big damn. He sent me something on
the... Yeah, he did.
You seen that?
Yeah.
I said, okay.
Yeah.
That nigga ignorant, man.
Man, that's about that nastiest nigga I know, man. I don't know what's up with it, man.
He's opaque ass.
Yeah. Yeah. I don't know. That's my dude, but that's a
that's
nasty
my dog.
Motherfucker, boy.
Listen, y'all. D. Cisco Grizzly is the man behind the trip to the Texan game. Even though I'm not a fan, I still live in Houston. Next year, we missed out a few times, but next year, we going to try and hit that bitch up and do that bitch right.
Yeah, we doing that, dog. The Dallas game got in my way this year.
So,
I got to drop shit.
Yeah.
When the Dallas game
happened. Well, you had a lot of shit going on. You had planned trips. You had the boy.
Oh, yeah.
You know.
Christening going on.
You had a lot of stuff going on. So, we harmfully regret to say that you fucked this shit up.
Thank you, man.
Yeah. But you next know. Year, we're going to find a game. We're going to find it quick, fast, in a hurry. This the NFL now. Yeah. I was marketing some shit. And we're going to let everybody know. Not that y'all gonna show up because y'all ain't fucking calling right now.
Oh,
but
man, like I say, man, they can't disagree. What they gonna do? I say, come on, man, I agree with you.
It's gonna be one game. We gonna find out which one that bitch is, and we gonna be that nigga.
Yeah,
that's gonna happen. Shoot from the hip show. Shoot from the hip. XYZ. Erica Mena versus Bow Wow. You remember? Are you familiar with this?
No.
All right. So Erica Mena is super thot. She was thotting back in the 90s, I guess when the Jay-Z's and Ja Rule's was always, you know, had.
Is this the one that turned gay and said she don't regret it?
Okay, hold on. So Erica Mena,
all right.
She was on Love & Hip Hop New
I'm
York.
I'm bearing the lead, my bad.
She was dating, what's that? Dollars Rich? Did Rich Dollars.
Rich Dollars.
She made, she also known for, she was DJ Envy's side piece for a while. Very attractive woman. Very attractive. I mean,
is this why he was apologizing on the talk show?
This is why he wanted to kill himself, too.
Oh wow, that's very light skinned of him.
He a bitch ass nigga.
He too. Man, he's the epitome of what light skinned
people. He got some suck ass nigga ways.
Yeah.
So anyway, then she was a super thot. You know, she got you know a lot of motherfuckers then fucked her. Well, Bow Wow decided to get engaged with her.
Wow.
Who's gonna marry the Duke's bad? His corny ass.
He is corny, something.
Yeah. So anyway, they've been going back and forth on social media. Bow Wow made some comments about thoughts, which if you taking any advice from Bow Wow or take anything he say serious, you are wrong.
Yeah.
Yeah. So anyway,
kinda like Trump, huh?
She felt like he was taking shots at her. She quickly chimed in and took some shots at him. And
is this recent or what, man?
Yeah, so he also came back with her and
He was trying to marry this girl.
He was trying to marry her.
And then what happened? He got mad at her about something, started calling her thot?
Bow Wow was being Bow Wow. He's a corny motherfucker.
Why did he get mad at her?
Who knows? But anyway, so Bow Wow, he said, look, check this out. Don't make me release the tape.
Yeah.
Because he said she got 500 bodies. And he said, well... She pretty much was like, but hey, what that mouth do though? Cause she was like, well, hey, I got 500 bottles. You shows eating my pussy though.
Hey.
Yeah. So it shows his corniness.
Wow, well.
I think she ain't got nothing to, and if he does release this tape, it just gonna help her.
Man, Bow Wow starting to turn into like a low key Kardashian.
He whack.
He keep putting out some silly shit every few months, dog.
Man, Bow Wow.
Remember when he's posing in front of the plane like it was his?
That, and then he had this one thing. He's running from a group of kids or some shit like that.
Yeah. Yeah. JD said, man, he's just trolling.
And then.
Don't put nothing on it.
And then America Mental was like, he also said he's going to commit suicide in front of her son.
Should have let him do it. Do it, nigga.
I know, right? That's what I always say.
I bet you won't do it. Do it.
Hey.
Anyway, man.
We got a few more things before we close out this episode of Shoot From His Show. So there was a man in his backyard. Apparently, he was reciting some words from a Jay-Z song. He said, I got 99 problems and a bitch ain't one.
Hit me.
Hit me.
Yeah.
Well, anyway, somebody thought he was on the other side of the fence beating his wife and they called the police on him.
Damn, without any visuals.
I guess not.
Was she? Did they hear screaming?
No.
They just heard him rapping.
He black.
Okay. Well, something about this don't sound right. How does this make the news? Okay, dog. You guys playing what that was. What was that?
Another siren.
Oh, nigga, that was a bad siren.
Okay, it was a bad siren. Anyway, he went to jail.
Hold on. Dude went to jail, and he was just him by himself in the backyard.
Apparently so. He said, I got 99 problems. He was quoting the words of a song. Somebody thought he was beating his wife, and they called the police.
Oh, man, he should have waited for the dog like the car did. You saw the law or something?
Yeah.
No, man. Something's wrong with that picture.
Yeah.
I don't even like the story. Something wrong happened there, though.
Do you Google, you'll find out more.
Okay.
All right. Black China.
That seems a little far-fetched, man.
No, it's true. Black China is
now y'all in the mic.
She's enduring a skin bleaching cream.
I saw this.
Called White Nicious.
And selling it in Africa.
Yeah.
How about that?
Supposed to use natural
chemicals. $250 a bottle.
A jar.
Jar, whatever.
Yeah.
Come on, dog. The self-hate can't be that real.
Hey, man, the lighter the better.
I think it's maybe that real in Hollywood. I think regular America don't give a shit about that.
Well, Nicki Minaj has gotten lighter.
You just keep saying that. She always seemed like she was like that to me.
She's gotten lighter, fatter, and all that kind of motherfucking shit.
Well, that's living good. That's just having money.
Yeah, that's called aging, too.
Well, she kind of aging.
Aging.
I was just fucking with you. I know. Anyway, man.
As I continue to
I can't believe that somebody's buying that shit. I guess I can believe it.
People, I can believe it.
I've seen the Lil' Kims and Sammy Sosa's and Michael Jackson's. I imagine it's a thing.
Michael Jackson? What? He got vitiligo.
Yeah. I guess so. Man, I don't know what that self-hate shit is about, man. No, man. I just so happen to come up in a family that's multicolored.
Yeah.
We got some dark ones. We got some high yellow ones. And so I've never been in a spot where I was color struck.
Me neither.
You know, so I don't get the whole thing, man. But I guess light skin makes more money.
Do it?
I've heard that said before. Not in regular world stuff, but like in entertainment business. Like, you know, you might get old. Like my son might be a millionaire.
Yeah.
Nigga, your son might be a millionaire. Why you tripping? But anyway, man.
Ready to close this thing out?
Yeah, we knocking
got
on
one more story.
All right, man. I like how you let me set it up for you and to knock me back
save
down.
It to the next episode.
No, let's put that bitch on out there. Don't ripcord it now.
Pusher T was in Toronto.
Hey, I got a joke for you real quick.
Go ahead.
Hey, what was the Clip's favorite drink?
I don't know, grinding.
Push a T. Dude, T. I got him for days.
Got him
for days. Okay, so what you got? What kind of hate
he
you
was
got
in Toronto
push a T?
And some dudes in
he was in the six?
Yeah.
All right.
OVO Clip.
There you go.
And somebody threw some water at him.
Hey, man. Pusher, mix it with some leaves and what you got?
Pusher T. A mojito. Pusher T said that Drake sent he paid goons to come after him at the concert.
See, Push is starting to turn into a Kardashian
he
too.
Yeah, I'm trying. Thank you, God. Because I've been trying to say this.
I saw him on an interview months after the shit, revisiting the shit. It was the Joe Budden thing, and it's like months after the fact. I'm like, why are you still even on this,
nigga? Nobody.
God, damn.
Why are you not working on you?
Hey, man, he's good.
He's not good.
He's Push. Ugh.
That nigga.
He's good.
Whack, dog.
You know, but anyway, yeah, I don't even know how that's news. Somebody threw some water on Nas Drake's fault.
Pretty much. That's what he's trying to do. But I don't believe it. And yeah, I'm a Drake fan, but it just sounds
yeah,
stupid.
Yeah, you were really anti-pushing.
He corny, man.
He's not as corny as Drake.
No, he's corny. Nah, well, no, he's Drake is in his lane, and he's in his lane.
He's corny in his lane.
Pusha T is in a he wanna be in a lane. He corny as fuck, and he whack. Both and he's of them irrelevant. 559-825-7465-559.
One of them think they can sing. The other one don't.
See,
don't
now we didn't brow zero into this bitch.
Well, here we go. You know zero saying circles around that boy.
Nigga, please.
Speaking of zero, I done heard this last album, and I'm not too enthused.
Nigga, the last five albums ain't been good.
Stop it. That's not true.
559-825-7468 is the phone number. 559-825-SHOT. Call us to leave us a voicemail. We want to hear from you guys. I know y'all haven't heard from us like y'all used to, so we want to hear from y'all. Give us a call. I know we done said something controversial. Maybe
it
not.
It wasn't me. I tell you that. Oh, it's all I did was spit the right stuff. Yeah, the truth. Yeah.
All right. Shootfromthehip.xyz is the website. Make sure y'all go to the left. Scroll down. Y'all see a donate button. Give us a donation. Make sure y'all search Shoot From The Hip Show on all social media outlets. Make sure y'all check me out. MANN_AT_ARMS is my Twitter. Make sure y'all hit us up. Somebody be hitting me up all the time. Is that Katie Davis?
Maybe.
Shout out to people who've been down with us and loyal to us. MONTOYSK on Twitter. Holla the Montoyis. Corey, who been fucking with us. Corey, I got some slick to say.
Yeah.
With those sorry ass in fantasy football. You know what? Fuck that.
Oh, shit.
Get on your ass. Oh, no,
man. Hold up, dog. You didn't got full of that Moscato.
Mm-hmm.
Want to talk some trash?
Just a little bit.
Hold up, man. I thought we was closing this thing out. Now you looking for something to do, huh?
No, I ain't looking for something to do. But so it's been a while, so we need to do this.
All right, man. All right. Fantasy update.
That's fantasy update. Right, let's go. Week 11.
Let's finish off with this here now.
Shutter Island smash two. Two, you looking bad. You got two wins. You need to straighten that shit out. Pack of niggas.
True to
his looking
name.
Bad. He got smashed by 30-something points almost or close to it. The Shutter of the Dead beat him. Corey P for North Clack. Bye, you 3-8, homeboy. Keep it up. You still got a chance. Durags and 10. Smoked him by, 11 points. For the black quarterback, DBYT, the shit-talking nigga that he is, he fucking took another L. He 3-8. The Haitian Hogan, he's from here.
So, that's called the Haitian.
We going to run into this nigga somewhere in this area, yeah, dog. Yeah. For real. He's here.
Yeah.
Him here.
Yeah.
All right, but he out here 7-4. Shout out to Carl Haitian, man. I fucks with Carl Haitian. The Dream Team, Flurleon. Flurleon one of the hottest niggas in the league.
Yeah.
Like one, five, six, seven in a row.
Ain't that a bitch.
It is. He think he's a great GM. He beat Cisco Grizzly. But Cisco Grizzly hanging on tough. He in the playoff. The Highlander, he smoked my boy A-Dub, 129-103. The Highlander, 9-2. Sure enough, is 1-10. Educated Ignorance, our man Dane Green scored 150 points. And let's get to these standings real quick.
Not very quick at all, huh?
That's quick.
Yeah, okay.
I got breath.
All right, nigga.
I got breath. All right.
Don't take your time. Man.
Let's start with number one is Shutter Island. I have clinched the playoff berth. I'm 9-2. We're going to go to the Highlander, which is our man up in Dallas. My man Keith from Dallas, he's 9-2.
Yeah, he's been preaching it.
Yeah. Educated Ignorance, he 9-2. 7-2 in his division. He number three. He clinched it. So myself, Keith from Dallas, and Dame Green, we all clinched playoff spots. The next spot goes to Haitian Hogan, the Dream Team, Durags and Tim, Unprotected Sex, and Deshaun of the Dead. Those are the top eight. It's still not over. I want to say we might have one or two more weeks in this league, but y'all keep it up. Keep updating your roster and shit. And we're going to get this thing crack-a-lack. I need to get Keith from that. Hey, call me, Keith. I need to get with you on getting that trophy ready so I can ship that thing out to whoever the winner is. As of right now, I'm the best in the league. I've been the best all fucking season long.
Don't pass it back too
nobody
hard,
fucking with your boy. I'm new to this. No, I'm sorry. I'm true to this. I'm not new to this. I'm a fucking sports anomaly. That's what I do. Can't nobody outsport me, dog. That's what I do.
Yeah.
It is what it is, baby. All
right.
I'm telling you, man. I
sound good.
Hey, it is what it is, man. Can I get my props?
Well, man, look here. When you win the thing, I give you props, dog.
I got to win?
You fall flat on your face,
so
dog.
The regular season don't count for nothing?
Not if you fall flat on your face, it don't.
Hey, man, let me tell you something, son. I'm the nigga.
I've been riddled with injuries, dog.
That what it is?
Yeah, because I had a good run going for a minute there.
Well, I think you had faith in the black quarterback is what I think happened. And I think he believed in that because him threw two interceptions. Not one, but two interceptions.
Him let me down his last game, but up to that point, it wasn't that bad.
Man, that nigga threw two picks, man. We appreciate y'all checking us out. This is the Shoot From The His Show. Y'all want Toys to Reach? There you go. Hope y'all enjoyed this episode. We out of here. Deuce out the booth. Deuce out the booth. Deuce out the booth. East side, come on. North side, come on. Come on. East side, come on. Come on. South side, come on. South west side, come on. Come on. Most city, come on. I'm done back.